Good morning. This is Breakfast with Charlie State and Susanna Reid.
Trapped 90 metres down.
It's a race against time to rescue four miners.
Of September.
We're live from the stricken mine in the... Penny will have all the business news for you. And Matt is live in Harrogate with the weather.
Matt, thank you very much. Good morning. First, our main story today. Specialist mine rescue teams are still searching for four missing workers in a flooded coal pit near Swansea.
Philip Hill, Charles Bresnan, David Powell and Gary Jenkins are trapped nearly 90 metres underground at the colliery in Pontydoa in the Swansea Valley. Rescuers hope the men are alive and were able to find pockets of air in which to shelter when water burst through a retaining wall and cut off their escape route.
Later, time now to get the news where you are. We'll see you in a moment.
Speaking of rock stars, Kaiser Chiefs are going to be here after 9 o'clock this morning.
And Matt's out and about with the weather.
Well, the Shadow Welsh Secretary Peter Hain joins us on the line. Can you describe the community and how they must be feeling well this morning? And I just want to ask you about the mine in particular. Just tell us a little bit about this mine. It's privately owned, as we understand. Some reports that the actual owner of the mine may be one of those men trapped. Is that the case? As Mr. Hain was doing that interview. Keep you up to date with that throughout the morning.
Absolutely.
To come up in the programme. As the hunt continues for the British tourist Judith Tebbutt, kidnapped in Kenya after her husband was murdered, we'll bring you the latest on the efforts to find her.
Matt's out and about today in Harrogate, in amongst beautiful flowers.
Across that press conference for you, 8:30 we're expecting that
to take place
this morning.
The local MP is Peter Hain, who of course is the Shadow Welsh Secretary. He has described the situation in the tunnel as a really bad situation. There's debris with sludge, he says, dark, murky water, and the divers obviously had a very difficult time. He said it's a grim... Imagine what they're going through. Right, well, we'll keep you up to date, as Charlie said, and as soon as that press conference happens, we'll either bring it to you live or we'll keep across what representatives, officials have been saying and bring it straight to you here on Breakfast.
7:50.
OK, if you are 68 years old, you could be thinking about taking things a little easier, a little quieter, perhaps putting your feet up. Not if you're a rock and roll legend, Sir Mick Jagger. He's gone and formed a supergroup called Super Heavy with Dave Stewart from Eurythmics, and it brings together as well Just Stone, Damian Marley and A.R. Rahman.
Well, when I caught up with Sir Mick, couldn't pass up the opportunity.
Your hands, or eyes at least, on a tablet.
Yes, they're of course somewhere between a laptop and a mobile phone.
Welcome back to Breakfast. For more than 14 years, Kaiser Chiefs have dominated the charts with their infectious... Is it not?
14 years?
It's a long time.
13 minutes past nine, the Kaiser Chiefs album, The Future is Medieval, is out now, and the boys are on their UK tour, 27th of January. And they finish up on the 23rd of February.
That's all from us at Breakfast this morning.